For this problem, assume that you have a fully functioning five-stage pipeline beta with full bypassing and annulment of branch delay slots as presented in lecture. This beta has been running the program shown here for a while. The actual functionality of this program is not so important for this problem, but let's just review it quickly. This program begins by initializing R1 to 0 before entering the loop. R1 represents the index of the array element currently being accessed. Within the loop, the value of that array element is loaded into R0. R1 is then incremented by 4 in order to point to the next element in the array. We then compare the array element that was just loaded into R0 with the updated index in R1, and if they are equal, then we repeat the loop. If they are not equal, then we store the current value of R1 into a memory location called index to remember which index value satisfied the compare instruction. We want to understand how this program would run on our beta. In order to do this, we will create a pipeline diagram showing the execution of this program. A pipeline diagram demonstrates which instruction is currently being executed in each of the five pipeline stages. Our rows indicate the pipeline stage that the instruction is in. There are five pipeline stages. The first is IF, or instruction fetch, which fetches the next instruction from memory. The second is RF, or register file, stage, which reads the source operands of the instruction. Next comes the ALU stage, where all required arithmetic and logic unit operations are executed. The fourth stage is the MEM stage, where we can begin accessing memory for a load or store operation because the address of the memory location was computed in the ALU stage. Finally, the last stage is WB, or the write back stage, where the results are written back into the register file. The columns in a pipeline diagram represent the execution cycles. Our loop begins with a load operation. So we see our load instruction in the IF stage in cycle 1001. The load operation then proceeds down the five stages of the pipelined beta. Next comes the ADD-C instruction. Since there is no dependency between the load and the ADD-C instruction, the ADD-C instruction begins in cycle 1002 and proceeds through all the five stages of the beta pipeline as well. Next comes the compare equal instruction. When we reach the compare equal instruction, we are met with our first data hazard caused by the fact that the load is updating R0 and the compare equal wants to read this new value of R0. Recall that a load does not produce its value until the write-back stage of the pipeline. This means that even with full bypassing logic, the compare equal instruction cannot read register R0 until the load is in the write-back stage. So we must initiate a stall of the pipeline in cycle 1004. The stall can be seen in our pipeline diagram in cycle 1005, where the compare equal has remained in the RF stage, and we have inserted a no-op in place of the compare equal that was coming down the pipe one cycle earlier. The instruction that follows the compare equal is the BNE. Notice that it entered the IF stage in cycle 1004, but it too was stalled by the compare equal, so the BNE remains in the IF stage while the compare equal is stuck in the RF stage. In cycle 1005, the compare equal is able to complete the read of its operands by using the bypass path from the write-back stage to read the updated value of R0, and by using the bypass path from the MEM stage to read the updated value of R1 produced by the ADD-C instruction. In cycle 1006, the compare equal instruction moves on to the ALU stage, and the BNE can move on to the RF stage. Since the compare equal is going to update the value of R2, which is the register that the BNE is trying to read, we need to make use of the bypass path from the ALU stage to the RF stage in order to provide the BNE with the result of the compare equal instruction in cycle 1006. The RF stage is also the stage when Z is generated. The Z signal tells the beta whether or not a register is equal to zero. This means that by the end of the RF stage in cycle 1006, the BNE will know whether it is repeating the loop or not. We now illustrate what happens to the pipeline diagram if the loop is repeated. In cycle 1006, the store instruction enters the IF stage of the pipeline because until we resolve whether a branch is taken or not, we assume that we should continue fetching the next instruction. If the BNE determines that it should branch back to loop, then this store instruction, which was just fetched, must be annulled by inserting a no-op in its place. The annulment is initiated in cycle 1006 and shows up as a no-op in the RF stage in cycle 1007. In cycle 1007, we also see that we now fetch the first instruction of the loop, which is the load instruction, so that we can repeat the loop. Here is a complete pipeline diagram showing repeated execution of the loop in our example code, together with the bypass paths being used, as well as the initiation of stalls and annulment of branch delay slots. We are now ready to answer a few questions about the execution of this loop on our beta. The first question we want to consider is which of the registers, R0, R1, and or R2, were read at least once directly from the register file rather than through a bypass path. Looking back at our completed pipeline diagram, we see that the load and add C instructions did not get their operands through bypass paths. Since both of those instructions read R1, that means that register R1 was read at least once directly from the register file. R0, which is only read by the compare equal, always comes from a bypass path. Similarly, R2, which is only read by the BNE, always comes from a bypass path as well. Next, we want to identify the cycle in which stall was set to 1 in the pipeline beta hardware. This occurs in the cycle where the stall is initiated, which was in cycle 1004. At the end of that cycle, the instructions that are currently in the IF and RF stage are stalled by not allowing a load of a new value into the instruction registers of that pipeline stage. Next, we want to determine in which cycle was a null IF not equal to zero. Recall that a null underscore stage control signals specify when an annulment is initiated in that particular stage. In order to initiate an annulment, then the instruction that is currently in the IF stage is replaced with a no-op. This occurs in the IF stage when we need to annul a branch delay slot. In our example, this occurs in cycle 1006. In which cycle was a null RF not equal to zero? This question is asking when an annulment was initiated in the RF stage. This occurred when the compare equal instruction needed to be stalled in the RF stage. In order to fill the pipeline bubbles, a no-op is inserted into the pipeline in place of the compare equal instruction that was in the RF stage in cycle 1004. The stall, and thus the setting of a null RF not equal to zero, occurs in cycle 1004. In which cycle was a null ALU not equal to zero? In other words, in which cycle did we initiate the replacement of an instruction in the ALU stage with a no-op? This does not occur in our example. Next, we want to consider our bypass paths. In which cycle was either bypass path coming from the ALU stage? In cycle 1006, the BNE reads the result of the compare equal instruction from the ALU stage. In which cycle was either bypass coming from the MEM stage? In cycle 1005, the compare equal reads the result of the ADD C instruction from the MEM stage. Finally, in which cycle was either bypass coming from the write-back stage? In cycle 1005, the compare equal reads the result of the load instruction from the write-back stage.